upbeat events to Just Improvising. Welcome to the show, Glenn.
Thank you so much for having me. It's great to be here, especially in such a live, living atmosphere. This is where I thrive.
Yeah, wonderful. So this will be a very exciting segment. Tell us about Just Improvise.
Let's hope. I always say lower your expectations and you'll never be disappointed. But, you know, let's see what we can
achieve. I've set it high now, so let's go. So tell us about Just Improvise. What is improvising for us that don't know what it is?
Well, the thing is, you do know what it is. Everybody knows what improvising is because we all do it every day. No one's had a script since they were born that they've had to follow. So the thing is, we all improvise every day. We're all actually really quite good at it. Mm-hmm. But I use improvisation to help people become more aware of how can they even improve more and really make those improvised moments of their lives a little more constructive or a bit more helpful than they otherwise have been.
Wonderful. And we were talking a bit earlier and you were talking about mindfulness and how important improvising is for being in the moment, focused but flexible.
Focused and flexible. Oh, or focused but flexible. Yeah.
I guess we're improvising, it doesn't matter, does it?
Look, it's a great training because all of the skills for improvisation and the things that we practice are really teaching us to be more present in every moment. Mm-hmm. So from moment to moment, being more present, not feeling shame, guilt or regret about the past, mm-hmm. and not feeling anxious or nervous about the future. Mm-hmm. And I always say to my students, don't be time travellers, mm-hmm. stay in the moment with me now. So.
Wonderful. And playfulness. Tell us about that and how it rolls into improvising.
Look, playfulness is one of those things that unfortunately, because of life and mortgages and relationships and children and schools and paying the bills and whatnot, we lose our sense of playfulness as adults. And kids love to play with junk, you know, or kids love to make things up for no reason other than to make things up.
And often I think, you know, even in the workplace when people have been doing the job for the same period of time, it helps them to be able to stretch their minds out, think about things flexibly, like we were saying before, but then bring it back to another solution. You can't do that, can you, if you're unable to improvise through situations?
Well, you have to be flexible. So you know what you're doing, but then you have to be flexible enough to chuck all of that out the window. And I think adults are still really playful. It's just there's less opportunities for them to engage in that playfulness.
Okay, so tell us about the classes and how people get involved. What's involved?
Well, we run classes for kids from the age of 6 all the way through to adults. So we have, and the idea for us is to make improvisation accessible for everybody. Even though I'm about to go and perform theatre sports and improvise for 1,800 people at the Enmore Theatre, improvisation isn't just about entertainment. Improvisation is what we do every day.
So it's like a life skill, really.
Well, improvisation is a conversation, just like we're having now.
And good for your well-being, because we know when we're connected, we're actually engaging with other human beings. It's important, isn't it?
And the thing is, so many communications that we have, if you think about emails and phone calls, so many communications are based on a function, right?
Yes.
That I'm having this communication with you in order to get this piece of information. So my bugbear is when people put their sentence in the subject heading of an email.
Yes.
Like you can't even be bothered to write words into an email and have a separate subject. Yeah. And so what I'm trying to do is say, look, not every communication has to have an end result or an end product.
Recreate a moment, right? You know, we can actually engage with somebody and get a response.
And if we know what we're going to get, we're either going to get that or we're not. But if we go into a conversation or a communication not knowing what's possible, then everything's possible.
Yeah, I really like that. So with the classes, when do they start?
You can get more information by going to justimprovise.com.au, and we'd love to hear from anybody. If you think improvisation isn't for you, it is, and it helps give people confidence, it helps give people a sense of belonging and a sense of place in the world and a connectedness.
Wonderful. Well, wonderful. I hope I encourage and I'm inspired by you. So thanks so much, Glenn, and hopefully we'll catch up with you again very soon.
That'd be great. Thanks, Nisha.
Thank you. That's all for now. Back to you, Fred.